quite like Las Vegas at night. Looks beautiful here at the Super 16 Gymnastics presented by Ozone. We're in the Orleans Arena, and here's the format tonight. Four teams on four different events, all going simultaneously. Oklahoma, they get to go Olympic order. They start on vault. Auburn will start on the uneven bars. The Wolverines on balance beam, and UCLA, always fun to watch. They will get things going on the floor exercise. Speaking of UCLA, they've got some star power on that team, and they've got a newcomer that's already got some star power. Selena Harris, number one recruit in the country, coming into this season as a freshman, and she is a local kid from Las Vegas, Nevada, Gymcats Gymnastic Club. So she'll be fun to watch getting her debut here, along with, of course, her teammate Jordan Childs in this 2023 season, Olympic silver medalist. But we've got a couple of our own special guests, as I like to call them. We have a little thing we like to call the Ozone Coaches Corner. We filled that corner with two coaching stars. 43 years she was the head coach of the LSU Tigers. That's Dee Dee Brough. And just a few years ago, the other gentleman next to her coached the Olympic champion to gold, Suni Lee. Jess Graba and Dee Dee Brough, take it away.
This is exciting. This is the exclamation point on this weekend. We've had great gymnastics, but tonight we're going to see 75 years of coaching experience among these coaches. That's a big deal. We've got so many extraordinary performers, but what's it going to take, Jeff?
Well, I think they got to get through the first event. You know, you put your hand up, get the nerves out as soon as you touch the equipment.
Right.
That's the main thing, and then everything will settle down and feel like normal again. I think that's the key. Get through this first one.
You're going to see the coaches really, really remain calm. This is a fabulous, fabulous group of coaches. This is a championship-level competition.
All right, thanks, coaches. We're going to go back to you guys throughout today's competition. Jess did not tell me he's wearing velvet. You know, I tried to step up my wardrobe a little, and then Jess turns around and puts on velvet. That's not fair. He looks too good.
Their outfits, slay.
On
they
point.
Look amazing. Dapper, if you will.
Oklahoma.
This is their world. We live in it.
Oklahoma, they will start on vault in an outstanding event for them. They are capable of eight on their team. 8-10-0 vault, so they should have six of those in the lineup here tonight. As we mentioned, Auburn will be on the uneven bars, Michigan on balance beam, UCLA on floor exercise. Allie Stern, the first gymnast to go here in tonight's competition, a fifth-year athlete out of Charlotte, North Carolina. And she has scored a 10-0 on this event. Yeah, you like the waiting game in gymnastics, Lori?
It is quite literally my least favorite thing in the world. Woohoo! Here we go.
Oh, she was going for the stuck landing, it looked like. Oh, just a little short.
She was going for that stuck landing. A lot of times when you expect the ground to come, you tend to open up a little bit early. That's what she did here, so that is why she took that step back, but very clean.
Now over to the balance beam, a tough place to start off a competition. Nerves are always on edge. Naomi Morrison gets things going for the 2021 NCAA team champions, Wolverines.
Not obvious already, her mount onto the beam counts as a skill, and it's terrifying. Begins with quite a big wobble on her flight series.
Naomi was the 17th ranked all-arounder in the country at the end of the regular season in 2022.
A lot of times you can tell when these athletes are nervous if you keep an eye on their ankles. If you see shaky ankles, it means they need a little more deep breaths before starting.
Allie Stern started off vault for Oklahoma with a 9.8.
Finishes with a stuck round off 1.5. Beautifully done. Quite a couple wobbles in that routine, so those tenths are going to add up. But let's see how she does.
As I mentioned, Auburn started with a 9.85 from their leadoff, Olivia Hollingsworth. Now Gabby McLaughlin is the second gymnast up for Auburn. junior from Irving, Texas, and Texas Dreams, coached by Kim Zemesko, world champion.
Maloney to Pack, really well done. Over on the blindfold, but finishes very strong. I'm very excited.
I know it's only two routines in, but two great routines for the Auburn Tigers. Back over to vault. Danny Sievers, the third gymnast to go. Danae Fletcher went in the two spot, a 9.825 for her. She also did a 10-0 vault. Again, the landing wasn't that clean, so in an event, Oklahoma should come out on top after the first rotation, giving away a couple tenths early.
Small controlled step on that landing, and I know some of you may be watching and be like, but 9.8, that's almost a perfect 10. And yes, it is, but every single tenth matters. Every flexed foot, every bent leg, every step on the landing, every wobble on beam, every handstand on bars that's not hit. Keep an eye out for those.
This is Emma Malabuyo for UCLA, the second gymnast to go. And in this session of all the sessions of this Super 16, these teams all ranked in the top 10 in the preseason. Nine nines are the name of the game for these teams. Nine nines are the norm. That's what it's going to take to win this meet. So anything lower, you start to worry.
Finishes or begins strong with a double back. Within the last two quads, artistry is a deduction that is now within the code of points. And in my opinion, Emma Malabuyo will not have any deductions. She is owning this floor tonight. Beautiful 180 split. No deductions on my end. A little wobble there. Comes the last pass. Routine for Emma Malabuyo. That's going to score nicely.
UCLA started with a 9.775 for their first gymnast. This is Jordan Bowers, one of the stars of the Oklahoma team.
Oh! Oh! Look at that! Oh, I love a good stuck landing.
Danny Sievers right before her, a 9.875. You felt like Danny could have got a 9.9. There's no denying this is going to be above that 9.9 threshold. Jordan really came out her freshman year and made a statement. Didn't do all around a lot because of balance beam. They're hoping to build her confidence a bit and get her in that lineup more often. She actually is doing the all around tonight, but certainly a fun gymnast to watch just in her sophomore year.
We've got Jordan Childs, Emma Malabuyo, talking to their teammate, Selena Harris, giving her some good luck pep talks.
I mean, if you're going to get a pep talk from a couple of athletes before you go, none other than Emma Malabuyo, who had an amazing elite career, and then Jordan Childs, who's on the top of her game right now. My goodness,
yeah.
I want to be in that conversation.
Those are the two to get some good energy from, and they're going to give it to you.
You love that Emma Malabuyo floor routine, and so did the judges. A 9.9, Jordan Bowers over on vault, a 9.975. So one of those judges gave her a 10. Scores building.
Starts off with a full end. Chest a little low. We'll be right back. out and double back second pass. Wow, full 180 splits on all her leaps and jumps. I think UCLA is really on their A game tonight.
I feel like this is a great place for them to start. They can just let it all out. They love to perform. If there are nerves, you feel like they just get rid of them right here on the first event.
I love this dream. Here she goes, last pass. 1.5 punch of front half to a double stack jump.
Not bad for a debut?
Not bad at all.
In front of her hometown crowd, as well as a contingent of UCLA fans. You can see them in the stands behind her. What a feeling. Well, you go from one outstanding performance to what I highly anticipate being another outstanding one. She is the Olympic all-around champion. Came into college gymnastics last year and lit it on fire. It's Suni Lee. She follows Darion Goborn's 9.9. I saw Suni do a routine in practice on beam that absolutely was a 10. Watch this routine and enjoy.
Oh, beautiful.
If she sticks it to 10.
Yeah, this is perfect.
Oh. Woo! A little flat on the full over.
Yeah,
do you
she
think,
did
you think
if
will the judges hit her on that? I mean, you're watching the Olympic champ, and she's the epitome of perfection.
She goes a little over on a full over.
Are you putting a 10th on that?
Personally,
you're the judge?
I might get a little for this, but she was a bit over on that blindfold. She did have a wobble on her landing, even though her feet didn't move. I am for sure being quite critical, but everything else was absolute perfection. And you don't get to say that about a lot of things in gymnastics.
I'm going 995. I'll agree with you.
We'll go back to that
in a moment, but here we go with Markzetta Fraser. Follows now a pair of 9.9s from UCLA. Selena Harris in her debut as a UCLA Bruin, 9.9.
Back first pass, she does step out of bounds. However, I will say, Mars is someone with brilliant stage presence. In this routine, I think she recognized she had a lot of power in that first pass and tried to hold back on the second, causing her to open a bit early. But I gotta say, that artistry, that is a performance right
there.
You did not lie
about that. The new head coach at UCLA, Janelle McDonald, did talk about Markzetta and how she's just come in this fall and put her head down and done the work and really gotten in shape. And That floor maybe didn't show all of that, but you certainly can see signs of greatness in there.
Absolutely.
Now Michigan, they are in a tough spot here early on balance beam. Started this rotation, the first three gymnasts did not break 9.8s. We saw Naomi Morrison with those wobbles, a 9.7 for her. The next two gymnasts also in the 9.7s, but Sierra Brooks, one of their star gymnasts, only a 9.2. In the fourth spot, and now one of their veterans, Abby High School, all the pressure on her. They can drop that low score. They can all drop that low, six gymnasts up. They count the top five scores, but she has got to hit
Just pretend. Another little wobble.
Michigan just a little shaky on this opening rotation.
Nice, beautiful, solid handspring layout. It's tough. You can train these routines over and over again, but if you don't remember to breathe in the middle of your routine and calm down those nerves, you're going to catch yourself wobbling during the season. Finishes with a beautiful round off 1.5. I gotta say, her form is stunning. Wonderful straight legs, pointed toes. That's what I like to see.
Abby High School is a graduate student now in her fifth year at Michigan. Also the Big Ten all-around champion from 2022. And now the world silver medalist. Just won a silver medal on this event a few months ago in Liverpool, Jordan Child. She follows Marzetta Frazier's 9.5, so they need a couple big scores here to finish through the Bruins.
Double layout, quite the large hop out of it.
Did stay
in bounds. Stunning, stood in bounds. She looks like she's having a blast out there. Front tuck to double back. It was perfect in my eyes. Stunning leaps and jumps. Jordan Childs finishes with a wonderful double pike.
Wow.
Woo! That was a show-stopping floor routine. Other than her landing on that first pass, what a fun watch. And she looked like she had such a blast out there. That is a huge differentiation between elite gymnastics and college gymnastics. When you're watching these floor routines, you get to see these athletes fully be themselves, and it really reads through the screen.
I would need oxygen after that routine. That was
fast forward
for the whole way. Now back over to balance beam. Natalie Wojcik for Michigan follows Abby High School's 9.825. As we mentioned, they have a 9.2 right now that they are counting that they will drop if Natalie can get a hit. She's the 2019 NCAA champion on this event. And was ranked in the top 10 on balance beam at the end of the regular season last year.
Handspring layout, small wobble there. I am noticing a lot of little bobbles on skills here and there, and they do add up. Hopefully Michigan can get those tents back on other events. It's a dismount. A stuck round off 1.5.
They needed that.
Oh, yeah.
Slow start, but they needed that hit from Natalie Wojcik at the end of that rotation. That was a big one for the Wolverines. Back over to floor exercise now with the junior Shea Campbell from Carrollton, Texas. Some of you may have heard of her dad, Calais Campbell, plays football in the NFL for the Ravens. Jordan Childs right before her. You're right about that landing. I think they got her a bit. 9.875. And in case you were wondering, we did nail the score for SUNY Lee. It is a 9.95.
Shea's first pass. Starts off with a near perfect full in.
a brilliant rotation.
Very clean front layout from Full. Her last pass. Fantastic routine for Shea Campbell. I think that's going to score very nicely.
I'm sure the coaches at UCLA will tell you it wasn't a perfect floor rotation, but find me a more entertaining one than that UCLA Bruin lineup on that event.
And aside from everyone trying to be perfect, it is so wonderful watching everyone just relax into it, have a blast on floor, and truly enjoy just being present in the moment, enjoying gymnastics for what it is.
So outstanding job for the Bruins on their first event of this 2023 season. Oklahoma wasn't perfect on vault either, but they may have the lead. We will find out after we get that UCLA score right after the break. Welcome back to Las Vegas and Super 16 Gymnastics presented by Ozone. We are in one rotation in, and it was a great one. Man, we have got a tight competition, and it was led by the high score of that rotation, sophomore Jordan Bowers. Lori, this was outstanding.
Wonderful, Yurchenko, 1.5. And a stuck landing. Who doesn't love that? Oh man, we only just started and I've had a blast.
And here are your scores in that first rotation. It is a virtual three-way tie at the top. Oklahoma has the lead, but Auburn and UCLA are tied just 0.025 behind the Sooners. Michigan, they have a little bit of work to do. They're 0.55 behind in fourth place. But a lot of gymnastics yet to come. We're gonna go down to the Ozone Coach's Corner. Jess and Deedee, what do you guys got?
All right, Gymnastics Nation. In case you're wondering, UCLA is back. Janelle McDowell has this team.
Wow.
They believe. Right. They tumbled, they leaped, they jumped, they did everything they needed to do to get the big one.
And then you got 49s flying off just everywhere right now. Oklahoma comes out. They don't know how to do anything other than a 10-0 vault. Like, everybody just, like, sticking landings, hitting their stuff. I think Auburn stuck five of their six landings.
They did.
Hit handstands. I mean, they came out ready to play. Everybody here looks ready to play.
Exactly. And that's the whole key to this competition. This is like a national championship Final Four feel. And these athletes are competing like it's the national championship.
Yep.
You know, if your team's not here, you're missing a lot of fun.
Yeah, and forget about what I said about being the nerves. I mean, it didn't look like that anybody felt it at all. So they're already settled down now. Now we're going to actually see when they feel comfortable.
Stuff. But I tell you what, Auburn did enough on bars over there. SUNY wrapped it up, but we saw handstands and stuck landings. That's a team to watch.
Yeah. Hopefully they can keep that thing rolling a little bit.
Yeah. Now the Big Ten team, Michigan, struggled a little bit on beam. They're coming back.
Agreed.
Thank you, guys. The leaders, the Oklahoma Sooners, they move to the uneven bars. Auburn Tigers, they go to balance beam. Michigan Wolverines, they move over to the floor exercise. As we mentioned, they have a little bit of catching up to do, but a couple great events for them coming up. And UCLA, after that outstanding floor rotation, they move over to the vault. I watched Oklahoma in training, Lori, and they're jockeying one of their lineup positions. Kat Lavasser's got a back issue. She's capable of a 10 on this event. But I was standing next to KJ Kindler, and they're looking for that gymnast to put in that spot. You know, what for you coming into a meet, when did your coach know, hey, you got it, or maybe, hey, we might have problems? Can you tell?
Are you saying, like, for lineup or knowing when the routine's going to be good?
From a gymnast perspective, you know, what you get going into a meet, when you feel it or you don't feel it.
Ooh, honestly, it really just goes by that face you have. You know, there's the look of determination right before you get on the equipment, and I think your coach can tell what that means. They've seen you do this over and over. So when you got that look in your eye, that's when everybody goes, oh, boy, better watch out.
Well, we're going to find out if Danny Sievers has it, because she is the gymnast that is in the lineup for Kat Lavasser. I watched her in training. She is outstanding. It's an embarrassment of riches for the Oklahoma Sooners throughout all four events, but definitely here on the uneven bars.
Begins with a Melonita Pack connection. It's like she's floating. 9 feet on. Get short on that pirouette.
Okay.
Full out dismount. Wow, that.
I think KJ Kindler is going to be happy with her decision. Not the flashiest routine like we saw from Suni Lee, for example, but hard to find a deduction in there.
For sure. I'm curious to know what her score is going to be. It's always a good thing when you finish that routine with a stick.
You know, it's going to start from a 10, and I have a hard time finding more than a tenth off, if that. So we will see what the Oklahoma score starts with. Marzetta Fraser for UCLA started on bar with a 9-8. And this is Amini in the second spot.
And then you put some closed shoulders on the table, so the height off of it was low. That affected the landing, so there's going to be a couple tenths in there.
Freshman Madison Animi from Sacramento, California, Techniques Gymnastics. Madison got a walk-on spot to UCLA just a few days before the roster was finalized. Really wanted to be on that team. Coach Janelle McDonald went and saw her practice, and they are thrilled to have her on the team. They said she is just driven, she's a hard worker, and the older teammates have really embraced her presence there. Now we're to balance beam. Olivia Hollingsworth for Auburn started with a 9.675. Again, if you've watched this meet for one rotation, you know that is absolutely a score you do not want to count. Now Aria Brush and the rest of the Auburn Tigers have a little pressure on them.
As we mentioned earlier, Michigan had quite a few wobbles on beam, so let's see how Auburn does with this rotation.
Ooh, that's a wobble.
She did get that connection, though, which is good. Handspring layup flight series, well done. Beautiful form. What's my forming? Gainer full. Aside from the little bobbles, it should score nicely.
Aria Brush delivers in an important spot for the Auburn Tigers. Now back over to vault for UCLA. Emily Lee, the sophomore from Los Gatos, California, three-time national team member, competed in the Tokyo Olympic Trials. Follows Maddie and Mimi's 9.775.
That was a near stick vault for Emily Lee.
That's going to score nicely. I keep saying that, but
and they keep scoring nicely. Danny Sievers scoring nicely at 9.875. Didn't get the 9.9 I thought she would, but for a leadoff score, that is big. Faith Torres in the two spot, also a 9.875.
For Emily Lee's vault, she was in the perfect position for that full she did off the table. A lot of times we'll see some gymnasts pike down to land. She did not do that. We don't see that often.
Oklahoma, meanwhile, is rolling on the bars. I'm being told that three huge stuck landings to start this rotation. I told you two 9.875s from Sievers and Torres, and then Danae Fletcher, who I watched in training as well. And I'll tell you what, Danae might not be a headliner on this Oklahoma Sooner team, but she looks outstanding. Remember that name. She got a 9.9 in the third spot. Back over to vault. Here's Shay Campbell following Emily Lee's 9.85.
Let's see if she can score higher.
Wow! Wow!
That was a monster ball. Holy moly. The height off that table, barely any landing deductions. Oh, my goodness.
I could stand under that with you on my shoulders, and we would be just fine.
We could run under twice, and she'd still be over our heads.
That was brilliant.
That is a 995 start value vault, so a perfect score would be a 995. It's going to be darn close to that. Now, quickly back over to the uneven bars. As I mentioned, in a Fletcher, a 99. Now, Reagan Smith, 2017 USA all-around champion and alternate on the 2016 Olympic team.
Here comes the dismount. Small hop on the landing. I did catch a few deductions there between missed handstands or rushed releases. But overall, her consistency on this event has really gotten better over the last few years.
Selena Harris, we saw that debut on floor with a 9.9. Shea Campbell, a big 9.925. That is what UCLA needs. Their first score over a 9.9 here in the second rotation. There's a 10-0 start value.
Just a small hop on that landing, but as I mentioned earlier with Emily Lee, when you have that beautiful laid out position in the air, there's not much they can deduct from.
The first rotation of this competition saw seven scores of 9.9 plus just between Auburn, Oklahoma, and UCLA. So the scores are starting to really flow here at the Super 16. Back over to Auburn on balance beam there, having continued troubles. We mentioned they started with a 9.675 from Olivia Hollingsworth. Aria Brushen, a very good 9.8. However, Cassie Stevens, only a 9.4. So three gymnasts to go. If they want to try to hang with Oklahoma and UCLA, they're going to have to start putting up 9.9s. This is Sophia Groth.
About that, I would be too. Handspring layout, back handspring, not a common three-part flight series we see on balance beam, but she nailed that. That may have supposed to lead to that skill right there, but she fixes it. You must have that connection in your routine, and she adds.
Sophia is a tough athlete. Just a couple weeks ago, landed on the bar, missed a hand, landed on the bar, cracked a rib. Whew. And she's back here in competition.
So far, a solid routine. Finishes with a pike gainer off the end, completely stuck. I gotta say, that's gonna score very high. And this is exactly what Auburn needs tonight.
She seemed pretty happy with it. Selena Harris, a 9.9 for that 10-0 vault. And now in the anchor position, Jordan Childs, as I mentioned, Olympic silver medalist, also a silver medalist on the vault at the 2022 World Championships, just behind her teammate, Jay Carey, who won gold.
Here she comes with a Yurchenko double full. Small hop on the landing, 10-0 start value. I'd be very happy about that.
UCLA finishing that rotation with Shea Campbell's 9.925, Selena Harris a 9.9, and this looks like it very well may break 9.9 as well, Lori.
I think it will.
Definitely a 1/10 hop. It is a 10-0 start, but other than that, a pretty darn clean Yurchenko double twist.
Jordan's also extremely consistent on vault. Every time she's competed on the elite scene, you can trust that she's going to hit a pretty gnarly Yurchenko double full like she just did and score pretty high on that event.
You saw the scores for Oklahoma on bars. Reagan Smith, Jordan Bowers, back-to-back 9.85s. Believe it or not, a little disappointing probably for the Oklahoma Sooners. Those scores typically are 9.9s, but Audrey Davis, she's as good as it gets on this event.
Beautiful invert to Pike Jaeger. Woof.
Wow.
Look at these handstands. When you got the toes to the ceiling like that, that's how you know you have a brilliant bar worker. Her legs glued together.
She has a unique dismount and sticks it all the time right here.
Woo! Beautiful. Yeah. What's so cool, you watch at the end as she's getting ready to do that half turn on her dismount. She spots the floor the entire time. No wonder why she sticks it. That was gorgeous.
So Audrey Davis ends it with an exclamation point. Could we have seen our first 10-0 in this competition? We'll find out in a few moments. But Michigan, we said they had some making up to do. They are not messing around. Three 9.925 in a row.
Ooh.
And Sierra Brooks and Gabby Wilson capable of perfection on this event to close it out for Michigan on floor.
Picks it off with a perfect pull in. Back leg, but so far this is a great routine. Double back. Michigan is on a roll right now. That's going to score very high.
Could it be a fourth 9-9 plus in a row? It certainly feels that way. Audrey Davis on bars. The judges somehow found a half a tenth in that routine, a 9-9-5 for her. That is a routine that's going to score. If she does an identical routine later in the season, she will be getting tens, kind of like Suni Lee, in my opinion. But let's go back over to Bean. Sophia Groth with a 9.85 for her routine. Gabby McLaughlin, a 9.825. So good scores, but keep in mind, they are going to have to count a 9.675. This feels like it really needs to be a 9.95 or better. Keep it close for Auburn after two rotations. Suni Lee.
She's got sticky feet so far. Nails that side aerial layout.
What a series, too.
Extremely difficult.
She's going to make it real hard for the judges not to throw a 10 tonight. The two routines she has had, stuck landing, virtual perfection, 9.95 on bars. You find me a way not to get a 10 on that one, Lori. Break it down.
Do you really want me to find it?
Find a way.
I am being so critical right now. That second layout step out was undercut a little bit. So if it's not a 10, I think that's where it is.
We're moving on to floor exercise. Sierra Brooks, a 9.95 in the fifth spot. So four scores in a row of 9.925 or better. And now here we go with the final gymnast for Michigan on floor, Gabby Wilson.
Wow, a monster full in first pass. She doesn't even grab her legs. She doesn't open. You have to be so strong for that.
Oh! Ooh.
Quite the hop on that double back. That's going to be a 10th or 2.
I don't think she went out of bounds. I looked quickly across the floor. Did not see the judge's hand going up, but that might break the streak of 9-9 pluses for Michigan. But nonetheless, wow, what a comeback performance for Michigan on floor exercise. But the story of the second rotation, she put up a 9-9-5 in the first rotation, and Suni Lee gives them no room to move. She gets a 10.
A perfect 10. You called it, John. Well deserved.
That was a beautiful routine.
One of, I'm sure, many more to come for Suni Lee here in the 2023 season. She has said that this will be her last collegiate season as she wants to train for the Olympics in Paris in 2024. But if it is, man, it is going to be a wild ride as she has already set the bar very high for the rest of the country. Wow, what a second rotation. It looks like Oklahoma still is going to have that lead, but with that 10, Auburn staying in it. UCLA right behind the Oklahoma Sooners. We got to wait for that last Michigan score to come in on floor, but they are going to be right in it too. We got a four-team race here in Las Vegas. Las Vegas is a city full of entertainment, but there's no better show than in the Orleans Arena here at the Super 16 Gymnastics presented by Ozone. It has been a great first two rotations. Audrey Davis, one of the highlights, this uneven bar routine.
Oh my goodness, look at these lines. The way she catches her releases, the perfect distance from the bar, stunning back salto to the low bar. I mean, I personally could not find anything wrong with this routine.
Well, the judges found a half tenth, which you and I both were wondering where it came from. So she did get a 9.95. That helps keep Oklahoma in the lead, but narrowly, because there were some big scores behind them from UCLA and Michigan, but none bigger than Olympic champion Suni Lee and her perfect 10 on beam.
I mean, she really did just have sticky feet on this event. No wobbles whatsoever. Execution was absolute perfection. Straight legs, pointed toes.
The scary part is it looks too easy for her. Oklahoma, they maintain the top spot. Actually extended that lead to a 10th of a point. UCLA in second, Auburn in third. Michigan closes the gap, but they are still in fourth place. We are gonna go to the Ozone Coach's Corner and down to the kids. Take it away, guys.
Okay. The excitement is here. Where do you start? The meet is close. The meet is Michigan, our Big Ten team, went to floor and crushed it. They were awesome. Nailed landings, did everything they could. They made up some ground, dug a hole on beam,
yep.
But Suni Lee getting a 10 for Auburn at the end of that
bailed
lineup.
Bailed them out.
They had a few mistakes, but you couldn't tell by the team. The enthusiasm and the emotion of the coaches, everything stayed the same.
This is what you need. You need it. Even if you make a mistake, you got to pick up the team because it's neck and neck. Every detail counts. Yeah. Every step's going to count here, and it seems like every team's in it.
Well, you know, you've been talking about bars. Oklahoma went over there and set the standard.
Yeah.
They hit handstands, bodies tight and locked. When you see a handstand on the top of that bar, it's got to be in a locked body position.
Fluid movements. Oh. Everything was smooth, easy to watch.
They came around under for their dismounts. It came under, tapped it nice and high. Stuck landings. That's the key
for the rest
of this meet.
Absolutely.
I think Jess and Didi are excited. Here, we're going to jump right into it. Natalie Wojcik leading it off for Michigan on ball.
Just a small hop on that landing. I will say her chest was down just a little. I feel like I'm being really critical here, but.
You gotta point out the deductions if they're there. People are gonna wonder where they found them, and that's one of them, certainly.
So true, bestie, thank you.
Natalie Wojcik, one of the veterans of this team. Michigan on vault is an unbelievable team. They have put up so many 10-0s in 2022. So again, we talk about them trying to make a move. It really feels like on what may be their best event, they've got to get this lead down to a manageable amount going into the fourth and final rotation. As they go over to bars, this is Shea Campbell for UCLA.
Begins with a Maloney to Bale. locked out handstand. That's what we like to see. Stuck double from Dusan.
Janelle McDonald, you can see her doing some gymnastics too on that mat. She's thrilled. And again, UCLA, they've got an energy to them and a positivity that is just going from one event to the other.
They sure do. I will say, as Didi mentioned earlier, UCLA has really stepped it up in today's competition.
Natalie Wojcik at 9.825. Now Reina Gugino had a little trouble in training on this vault. We'll see how she does here. Not a problem. Hop backwards.
Just as you mentioned, small hop backwards. Let's see this replay. Okay, she did have some closed shoulders on the tables and leg separations in the air. So if you see some tenths off from her score, I do believe that's where they would pull from.
Now the leaders, Oklahoma Sooners. Ava Siegfeld will be the second gymnast to go as KJ Kindler comes up and gives her some smiles. I asked KJ one time, when you're talking to the gymnast, do you actually think they're listening to you? or is it more of an exercise for you and your nerves? And said, you know, you never know, but it is different for each gymnast. She knows what each one needs and what to remind them, right?
Yeah, I used to ask for someone to talk to me right before going, and I would genuinely express, I'm not going to respond back to you, but I could use a distraction from my own nerves. So I just have people talking to me left and right.
KJ does love coaching balance beam, takes great pride in how good the Oklahoma Sooners beam team has been over the years. Reina Gugino on vault for Michigan at 9.85, so builds a little bit, half a quarter of a tenth rather higher than Natalie Wojcik. They have four left to go. Shea Campbell gets a 9.825 to lead things off for UCLA on bars. And Auburn on floor, Gabby McLaughlin just a 9.65. So we saw that from Auburn on beam. They started slow. Jenna Dunn's score finally in for Oklahoma. She led things off for the Sooners, 9.85 for her. Ava is a freshman from Williamsburg, Virginia, and world-class gymnastics, where she is coached by Tammy and Rex Harrison. Competed in the 2021 Olympic trials, finished 14th all around there.
Begins with a genuinely perfect handspring layout. That was one of the prettiest flight series I think I've ever seen. Nails her front aerial. Things are looking good so far for Ava. Absolutely gets credit for that ring jump. Her head was all the way back. Her leg in the back was bent enough.
Beautiful.
Woo! I gotta say, that may be a perfect 10.
In the two spot, second gymnast up. Lori Hernandez telling me she can't find deductions. Getting an extra long hug from KJ, probably a good sign if you're a Sooner.
I like to, well, not like to, but I unfortunately tend to always find deductions, so.
Well, and that's the nature of the sport, right? You can always find something that could be higher could be split more, but.
Absolutely.
In our world, that was pretty darn good. I'll tell you what, there's an energy in this arena right now that is a championship type of energy.
Yes.
Great gymnastics in all four corners on all four events. Michigan bringing it on vault. They started with a 9.825, and it went up through their fourth to a 9.875. This is Sierra Brooks in the anchor position.
Goodness.
Bev Palocki right there. I looked over and I saw the double fist pump from Bev. She's been around this court for a long time, been at Michigan for 34 years, but she still gets excited for greatness. All right, now Selena Harris and the UCLA Bruins on bars trying to keep pace. Paterariu in the third spot for UCLA, 9.85. That's their highest score so far in this rotation.
Beautiful Bailey handstand. She began with a Ray release move.
Wow.
We are seeing some fire gymnastics today. Holy moly.
Did somebody tell me she's a freshman? Because she doesn't compete like a freshman. Wow. Selena Harris, 8 times she won a JO national title. And you can see why she is rated the number one recruit in the country coming into this 2023 season.
Ava on beam did get a 9.925, so it wasn't a perfect 10, and now I want to go inquire where the judges found.
I love it when Lori starts inquiring. You know that's a good sign for the athlete.
It was beautiful.
Gymnastics.
So that was Sierra Brooks who went on vault, but I mistakenly said she was the anchor on that event. She is not. She was in the 5 spot, and she got a 9.95. Abby High School is yet to go for Michigan. And she is capable of a 10, has gotten a 10, as we see Jordan Bowers on balance beam now for the Sooners. Third gymnast up there.
Absolutely stunning handspring layout.
Jordan Bowers, a very good beam worker, however, did not get in the all-around competition all that often last season, as I mentioned earlier, because of balance beam and a little bit of her confidence on balance beam. Got in today because of Kat Levaster's injury and certainly looks to be making the most of it right now. Going to make lineup choices real difficult for KJ.
Oh, boy, yeah, it will. And I got to say, all of Oklahoma's flight series that we've watched so far, they have been jaw-dropping. Straight legs, pointed toes, no wobbles. Beautiful height on the layout step out. Here comes the dismount. Tiny little step.
You're saying it was a small. You're saying it was a small step.
The tiniest.
What's the deduction for a tiny step?
The tiniest little.
That is a new dismount for Jordan Bowers. A double twist. Been working to clean that up as we quickly go over to bars now. UCLA's Jordan Childs follows a 9.9. from Selena Harris.
Huge pike to catch of Takat.
Watch this.
Maloney to Ginger. Look at those handstands.
A 1 foot slid, or I was about to call for another 10. That was a fabulous bar routine. The handstands, Lori.
Handstands,
did they get better than that?
Truly, handstands. Also, something that we have to commend Jordan Childs for is the height that she gets on those release moves. Competing in the Elite World, she was doing Takachev after Takachev, just connecting things left and right. And her height was brilliant. You would expect to see something like that from someone tumbling on the floor, but she was able to get that on bars.
And like Suni Lee's bar routine, she did more difficulty than she needs to do to get to a 10.
Yes.
But they're competing elite. They're trying to make an Olympic team. And a lot of these coaches who are coaching elite athletes that are competing college, they have them do more difficulty. And they incorporate a lot of those skills they do in elite routines into their college routine by design. And that's a risk they take. But it's worth it to have these type of athletes like Suni Lee, like Jordan Childs on your team.
Absolutely, and especially knowing, as you mentioned, that they are still flicking back and forth between collegiate and the elite scene. They have to keep those skills up to date.
Suni Lee, the 10 on balance beam, now goes to floor exercise. Follows Cassie Stevens, 9.85. A slow start for Auburn here, 9.65, 9.775 for their first two athletes.
Double layout, first pass for Suni Lee. You can see she's really bringing the energy here. Perfect loose jumps. pass. 1.5 from full, small hop on that landing, but.
Looks like she said something to herself at the end of that floor pass. Her lips move. I wonder what she said.
I think she might have.
Another outstanding routine, just that hop. Maybe a tenth, maybe a half a tenth.
Should score very high, though.
Jordan Childs did score very high, 9.975. So one of the judges did give her a 10. Mark Zetta Frazier right after her. And this happened a moment ago. I won't give away the ending, but it was good.
Spoilers. Stunning connection for her Maloney to pack. Little short on that pirouette, but she keeps things moving. Oh, that was beautiful. I sound like a broken record for tonight. I mean, all of this gymnastics that we're seeing is of such high quality. It is such a joy to watch, truly.
A much anticipated quad meet coming into this weekend with all these highly ranked teams, and so far it is absolutely delivering. Mark Zetta Frazier, 9.95 for that uneven bar routine. Back over to balance beam for the Sooners. Jordan Bauer is a 9.925. Audrey Davis right after her, a 9.8. Now this is Faith Torres, the prize recruit for the Sooners, former elite gymnast as well. KJ has so many great things to say about her and her gymnastics. Calls this her best event.
Hey, that's a wonderful title hold. Side aerial to layout step out. Such a difficult flight series. The half turn you do in the air on the side aerial and going right into a layout step out. Oof.
Oklahoma held only a 1/10 lead over UCLA, who sat in the second spot after the second rotation. This feels like it needs to be a big number to stay there.
Round of double back dismount. That was a pretty solid step on the landing.
It's
maybe
okay to say
tiny,
it was a big
maybe
step.
Not a tiny, tiny step. That was a step.
It was a 1/10 step for sure. And that's a risky dismount. You see a lot of the 1.5s, the gainers, which are easier
yes.
to stick. Taking a big risk there. Now this is a must-see routine. This is Darion Goborn, choreographed her routine with her brother, and I'm told that this routine is a tribute to historically black colleges and universities, and it is one you will absolutely want to sit back and enjoy.
Double tuck first pass. She doesn't grab her legs. That is difficult. Front layout. Nails it. Here she comes for her last pass. Beautiful double pike.
We'll never get tired of watching Darion Goborn work the floor exercise. So happy to see her come back for a fifth year. Suni Lee, 9.9 right before Darion, by the way. Faith Torres in her freshman debut on the balance beam, a 9.9 for her. Now Reagan Smith, who knows pressure situations. It was Reagan on balance beam at the NCAA championships that hit her routine to clinch the national title for the Sooners, the fifth for KJ Kindler.
Strong routine for Reagan Smith. Oklahoma has brought the heat for balance beam. Let's see how much they carry to floor.
Outstanding finish for the Sooners. Reagan Smith doing what she has done throughout her career at Oklahoma. The 9.9 plus scores are flying here at Orleans Arena in the final quad meet here of the Super 16 gymnastics. Jordan Childs, Suni Lee, three rotations. It's razor thin. We'll have rotation four when we come back. Welcome back to Las Vegas, the Super 16 Gymnastics presented by Ozone. John Roethlisberger, Lori Hernandez, as we enter the fourth rotation of what has been an unbelievable competition. There was a lot of hype about this session, and it has not disappointed. One of the highlights, Jordan Childs on uneven bars.
Kicks things off with her pike to back to pack. I mean, her releases are just so high. Right to Ginger. Woo! Jordan really brings the wow factor on the uneven bars. Finishes with a full and dismount, barely a step on that landing. And lots of excitement.
9.975 for that uneven bar routine. It keeps it close for UCLA. They sit in the second spot. Now just 0.075, less than a tenth behind OU. Auburn and Michigan just a bit behind. Auburn now half a point, 0.5 behind. Michigan 0.55 behind. Might need a little bit of help from those top two teams to jump back in the first position, but it is gonna be a close one down the stretch. I'm a little worried about Jess and Didi. That was a pretty exciting rotation. Do they need to be resuscitated down in the Ozone coach's corner?
I need oxygen after that, no, that's for sure,
I'm
don't you?
I'm telling you what, it's high in here. These teams are cranking. They're hitting on all cylinders. The coaches are excited, but they are maintaining that excitement to keep these athletes focused. They've got blinders on. UCLA went to bars, now they're on beam, and they did a great job, did enough
They've
to
been riding the wave a little,
solid
yeah.
Solid second.
Yep. It's going to be kind of touchy here because you got to ride. If you end on one of the energy events,
yeah.
you can keep riding that wave. When you get to one of the events where you got to be a little technical,
right.
that energy, you need to kind of like even it out a little bit. We'll see if they can do it, but it's anybody's game
I've
right now.
I liked Auburn's rotation. I like that rotation a lot. They get to finish on vaulting. I think they're a
they
solid.
They need to stick a full, yeah. And they need to hit their 410
vaults.
If they do that, then they,
Oklahoma,
we got four teams going 197
Oklahoma
tonight.
Oklahoma is not going to falter. This team's got the attitude. It's all business. Been there, done
yep.
that. They're, expect them to
day
give
in,
you a
out.
Great performance.
Yeah.
UCLA, I'm not sure. I don't know what's going to happen. They had a lot of enthusiasm on bars. They did a good job on bars. They're coming over here in second place. If the coaches can stay contained, stay inside
calm
themselves,
them down. Yeah.
calm down.
Maybe even the coaches need to calm down a little bit.
But they're a little freshmen.
We were jumping around a little on bars.
Their Las Vegas freshman is doing a fabulous job. Selena is doing a great job for them. And, you know, coming off an injury.
Looks like they got two freshmen going on beam right now.
So, I mean, she's got them together. She's doing a great job. So this rotation, it could be anybody's meet.
Anybody's game right now.
Oklahoma is leading.
You won't
solid.
See a major mistake, but you might see a couple wobbles here and there, and that's what that could make the difference. difference.
Well, maintaining your chest position on your landings and sticking, but letting your chest move forward, you've loaded up that landing and you're not going to be able to control.
Better go big right now. Go
That's
big.
That's right.
Thank you, guys. You know, I want to go back to the Ozone Coach's Corner sometime and see those two disagree. I think it would be a fun segment.
That needs its own show in itself.
So here we are going into the fourth and final rotation. Auburn will be on vault, Michigan on uneven bars, UCLA on balance beam. They're just less than the 10th behind Oklahoma, but finishing on beam, a tough spot to be in. Oklahoma, they are on floor exercise again. Every event's good for Oklahoma, so they need to land on their feet. So far in this competition, there's been 26 scores that have been 9-9 or better, and that includes the 10-0 from SUNY Lee. And I was talking to the former head coach of Alabama Crimson Tide, Dana Duckworth, on the break, and she mentioned how impressive it is that the stamina and dance and the conditioning of these athletes on the first weekend of the competition is certainly a new standard, as now we go to balance beam with Emily Lee leading things off for the Bruins.
I gotta say, Emily Lee's beam is so mesmerizing to watch. Absolute perfection on that handspring layout. She is a breath of fresh air. It's like meditating watching her. The same energy she gives off when she does beam. A little wobble there, that's a broken connection. But the same energy I get when watching her, I get when I used to see Kyla Ross.
Kyla Ross, of course, the great UCLA Bruin, arguably one of the greatest collegiate gymnasts in history, and Olympic champion.
Duck gainer full off the side. There were a couple connection breaks, wobbles. That's gonna cost her a bit, but I do believe the team can make this up.
Well, you gotta stay on. You get through those first few routines, hopefully minimize any errors, and then hopefully you got some big scores like UCLA has done all night. They've finished with gigantic scores on each rotation. Now, Auburn on vault. The one thing Auburn has not done well is start strong on their last couple events. They have got to come out of the gate strong, and they do on vault. Sophia Groth, 9.825 in the leadoff position. You heard Jess talk about the 410-0 vaults. They are supposed to do 410-0 vaults. They can stick one of these early vaults, their 9.95 start values, and then put the exclamation point on. They've got a half a point to make up. That is a lot. They got to be almost perfect.
Also, I just have to say, Harry Styles is floor music right now, and I'm having a really good time. I love Harry Styles. Okay. Okay, that was very nice, Yurchenko full.
Beautiful
point
in the air.
Hop back.
Yeah, big hop on the landing. That will for sure be a 10th, so that'll be in the 9.8s. But again, four big vaults yet to come for Auburn. They better be big. You want to chase down UCLA and Oklahoma now. Back over to balance beam as Shea Campbell does the waiting game. We've seen this a lot throughout the first weekend of gymnastics. And you think the first weekend for the judges, too.
Oh, yeah.
They got some rust to kick off, you think?
Well, you know, it was just the holiday seasons. Everybody's hopefully home with their family or friends, or essentially that's the same thing. But when you got to dust off those feathers and come to a competition like this, I'm sure it can be quite a joy to watch, especially with the energy that's going on in the competition today.
Shea Campbell waits. Meanwhile, Oklahoma on floor. They started with Belle Johnson, 9.85. Abby Heiskell on bars for Michigan. Get this. In the leadoff spot, a 9.925. You know, Michigan has been battling from the fourth spot all night, and now they could be making a move. Could they jump to first as we go to floor? This is Audrey Davis.
For handspring front, double full, beautifully done. As I've mentioned earlier in the day, artistry is now something that can be deducted from floor routines. So if the rhythm is off, if the music or dancing doesn't suit the personality of the gymnast, they can get deducted for that. But she's slaying right now. And the half front full. Yeah.
Audrey Davis, outstanding. At the end of last season, was the 15th ranked all-arounder in the country. At the end of the regular season, been outstanding for the Sooners now. Finishing the waiting game, hopefully, for the Bruins is Shea Campbell, and you can see Emily Lee, a 9.3
that is
in the leadoff spot. So to put that in perspective, again, they can drop that score. But here UCLA comes into the fourth and final event, 1/10 behind the defending champ Sooners. They have a mistake in their first gymnast. 5 scores left. The pressure is on these athletes. You feel like they all have got to hit home runs.
Emily did miss a lot of connections because of her wobbles, so that's where that low score comes from. But Shea up here begins with a beautiful handspring layout. No wobbles on my end that I can see. Ooh, that is quite a big wobble. Like the beam shook a bit there too. Leap to switch half and flutter jump. Well done. Finishes with a gainer full. And a big sigh of relief that it's over. She made a little face like, ooh.
Meanwhile, over on the vault, Sarah Hubbard in the third spot. I did glance up. She stuck her Yurchenko 1.5. She gets a 9.9. That is the first of their 4-10-0 vaults. Here we go with Suni Lee.
Other than the step on the landing, I didn't find anything.
Now, I saw her do that vault last year in the laid out position. I'm not sure if that was the plan here, to do it in the tuck position or not.
I think in practice, I saw her do this vault a couple times, so I do believe it was intentional. But, well, of course, Suni has the capacity to do both, right?
She learned that vault in like a minute, I feel like, last season. I remember thinking to myself, only an Olympic champion. So an impressive night for Suni Lee. She is done competing. Cassie Stevens, by the way, was right before Suni on vault, a 9.925 for her. So Darion Goldborn is the last vaulter for Auburn. Again, UCLA, Auburn, Michigan, trying to chase down Oklahoma. UCLA having some trouble on balance beam. Shea Campbell, just a 9.65 for her performance. Now, they will have to count that 9.65. Jordan Childs is the next gymnast to go.
We're going to need some really high nines, but unfortunately, the 9.6, it can go both ways. When that score counts, it really just depends on everybody else competing afterwards and seeing how high of a score they can get.
Yeah, as tight as this competition feels, a 9.65, it's going to be a problem for UCLA unless they can put up some big numbers. At least that's the way this competition is going. Oklahoma on floor, Audrey Davis a 9.9, Danae Fletcher in the third spot a 9.925. So pressure situation for Jordan Childs.
Beautiful handspring layout, wonderful height, no wobbles, perfect form. Jordan genuinely has the capacity to wow the judges on this event. It's just a matter of hitting a beautiful routine under pressure. She can do it. Let's see what she does. She wanted to wobble there, but saved it. Here comes the dismount.
Oh! The double pike!
Oh, boy.
Could we have our second perfect 10 on balance beam here at the Super 16? Jordan Childs, I'll tell you what. She delivers over and over again, whether it's for the Bruins or Team USA this fall at the World Championships. Back in college here in January, she is just relentless competitor.
I'm really curious to know what score she's going to get. If she doesn't get a 10, I would say it's because of the chest down on the dismount. But also, that's me being nitpicky.
We shall see as Reagan Smith the fourth gymnast to go for Oklahoma. They are rolling on floor exercise right now while Michigan's continuing to roll on the uneven bars. We'll update you with that in a moment.
Practically perfect double tuck first pass. Punch front layout, a couple stumbles back on that. Here comes her last pass. Double pike, well done.
Wow.
That was a pretty solid routine for Reagan.
Very well done for Reagan Smith. As I mentioned, 9-9, 9-9-2-5 right before her. Michigan on bars. They have been cruising, I'm being told. Five legit stuck dismounts out of six routines. And the highlight, this was moments ago, I should say one of the highlights. There were a lot of highlights for Michigan on bars. This is Sierra Brooks, the fifth gymnast to go for the Wolverines, trying to make a run from the fourth position throughout every rotation tonight.
Stunning shoot over to the low bar. Hits right to a dead handstand.
Double high fives from Scott Sherman, the uneven bar whisperer, I like to call him. One of the best bar coaches in the country, and you can see his craft at work. 9.95 from Sierra Brooks.
Ooh, that was a monster dismount.
That was the third 9.9 plus for Michigan. And at that point, they still had Natalie Wojcik yet to go. Speaking of Natalie Wojcik, this was also moments ago, and this was the capper for the Wolverines.
Short on that first handstand.
One of the best releases in all of women's college gymnastics right there. Beautiful, Delchev.
It always throws me off when it happens. I never know it's coming. So well done on her end. Wow. We're seeing greatness tonight, that's for sure.
Well done from Natalie Wojcik. Back over to balance beam. Jordan Childs, a 9-9. You were right about the shoulders down, most likely on that dismount. I'll give you that one, Lori. Sienna Alipio, a 9.75. For UCLA in the four spot as Selena Harris mounts the beam. So UCLA now counting a 9.75 and a 9.65. It does feel like that the opportunity to win this meet and very likely the second position may be slipping away from the Bruins.
Handspring layout, handspring. Beautifully done. Sometimes with the momentum on that layout step out, it can be hard to tame the back handspring after it. But she does it well.
Auburn and Michigan, they are both done with this rotation. UCLA has one gymnast to go. Oklahoma has one gymnast to go. She wanted to stick that so bad. She opened that up, looked for the landing. You can see the kind of double fist squeeze above her head, like, oh, let that 10th get away. But what a night. What a debut for that freshman. We're going to jump over to floor exercise. Oklahoma Sooners finishing up with Jordan Bowers. At the end of last season, she was the 19th ranked gymnast in the country on this event. And she follows Faith Torres, the other freshman star here this evening. She got a 9.95 for her floor team.
Height on that double pike. So it was like a stump front tuck. Moved through it smoothly, though. I would just lay there and take a nap afterwards. I'd be so tired, I would not get back up. That's enough for me on my end.
You took the words right out of my mouth. Jordan Bowers finishes things up on what looks to be another Oklahoma Sooner victory, picking up right where they left off after the national championship last year. Final gymnast to go for UCLA on balance beam. This is Emma Malabuyo. Selena Harris scored a 9.8.
Here for Emma Malabuyo. She is someone you can definitely count on for beam. Always shows up, especially in the elite world, someone you could count on.
Five-time national team member, Olympic alternate in 2020.
It's like she wants to wobble, but just covers it up with a little dance. That's what you gotta do. And no skill is rarely perfect every single time, so you just keep moving when you land. Wonderful routine for Emma Malabuyo. Curious to know how this is going to affect UCLA's overall score.
It is going to be interesting to see this last number come in, because again, Auburn puts up a 49.5 on vault. Michigan put up a 49.6 on the uneven bars. Obviously, Oklahoma, a big number on floor. Jordan Bowers finishes with a 9.9. They went 49.525. So the question now really is whether UCLA can stay ahead of either Michigan or Auburn. They're not going to catch the defending champ Sooners, but we will flush that all out. We will talk to our guests one more time, but what a competition here in Las Vegas. The Super 16 did not disappoint. The headliners, they delivered.
Hey, Joe.
And watch anytime on Hulu.
The Super 16 is brought to you by Ozone Leotards, Paradigm Treatment, and the Las Vegas Convention and Visitors Bureau. Your results, Oklahoma, they do get the win with a monster 197.925. You think 198 by the end of the season, but wow, almost got there here in the first meet. It is Michigan. They were in fourth place the entire night until the last rotation. They put together a big one. They jump all the way to second. They move ahead of Auburn by half a tenth. Auburn finishes in third. UCLA, who is flirting with the top spot after rotations 2 and 3, unfortunately on balance beam, that dropped them down to fourth place. Lori, when this schedule came out and people saw this matchup of Oklahoma, Auburn, Michigan, and UCLA, everyone thought, wow, this is going to be great. But I think it exceeded expectations.
Absolutely. I mean, just as you mentioned before, with Oklahoma almost having that 198 all-around score, that is monster for the first meet of the season. So I think we're going to see some greatness from them all year round, if I'm being honest.
I think one of the questions that was brought up to me during the break, too, was, How do you maintain this now? You're at a score that could win a national championship week one if you're Oklahoma, but even the other teams looked outstanding. How do you kind of keep that high throughout the next, 16 weeks?
Yeah, I mean, we've been saying throughout the whole day that every tenth matters. Those steps on the landing, wobbles on beam, anything like that. So keeping those in mind, but at the end of the day, everybody just has to be healthy. If you're healthy, then you can achieve anything.
Well, there are a lot of highlights in tonight's competition, but definitely one of the highlights for Oklahoma is Jordan Bowers. Jordan, just a sophomore, you came out last year as a freshman. Outstanding year. You guys won the national title. How do you guys keep doing this?
We just go in and day out, and we do what we know how to do, and we trust ourselves and we trust our coaches, and that's all that we can do.
Were there any highlights from your meet today?
I did my new release on bars, which was good. Stuck my vault. I was back on beam, and that was an amazing feeling, and got my new floor routine, and it was just a great day.
Jordan, you did all around today. Beam isn't something that you normally get to do. Do you think maybe the all around is something? You're going to make it hard on KJ. You put up over a 9.9 there. Are you going to be in the theme lineup some more? Are you going to keep doing all around?
I would hope so. I got to keep proving myself and going day in and knowing that I can do it and just trusting myself and going out there and doing the same exact thing.
Yeah, on that same note, do you have any goals for this upcoming season?
Keep improving as a team and individually, keep improving on confidence and just trusting ourselves and putting out there like everything that we can do, and that's all we can do.
Love that.
Well, Jordan, the Oklahoma Sooners never seem to disappoint. You guys are a lot of fun to watch.
Thank you.
Great team chemistry. Good luck the rest of the way. Hope you guys stay healthy and keep rolling on. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
A outstanding performance again for the Oklahoma Sooners. A 197.925 almost breaks that coveted 198 barrier. We are not done here from Las Vegas, however. When we come back, we're going to talk to the Olympic all-around champion and her club coach, Jess Graba. Back at the Super 16 Gymnastics presented by Ozone. Again, Oklahoma gets the big win. What a performance they put up. Michigan battled all night, started themselves in a deficit after the first rotation, but kept plugging away. Closed the gap and then jumped from fourth to second on the last rotation. The Auburn Tigers, led by Olympic champion Suni Lee, they finish in third, drop down there after that last rotation. UCLA in second through the second and third rotations, but can't hold on the balance beam. Again, the balance beam proving to be troublesome for a number of teams in today's competition. They finish in fourth place, but I think for UCLA, a lot of fans of UCLA watching them, waiting to see what they're going to look like. And I got to say, they probably delivered for their fans. Wouldn't you agree?
I would definitely agree. I mean, they started off on, in my opinion, what's one of their strongest events, which is floor exercise. And they set the bar really quite high. I mean, just in terms of entertainment, I could not keep my eyes off of them.
No one entertains like the UCLA Bruins. Well, we told you we're going to have an Olympic champion and her coach, Suni Lee, is with her coach, Jess Graba. Take it away, guys.
All right, Suni. First thing first, we'll talk about the meet. How did you feel after the meet? You feel like you kind of accomplished what you came here to do?
I think so. I mean, I feel like I had a couple of hiccups, but it's the first meet of the season. We have so much longer to go, and it's been pretty difficult trying to balance everything out since I'm trying to come back to Elite as well. So I'm just taking it day by day.
Well, let's talk about that. Coming back to Elite. Mm-hmm. Now you got to come back to NCAA. We've had to tweak routines, I'm assuming, and all this stuff that's happening last second. Explain, talk a little bit about that, the difficulty.
Yeah, it's been pretty difficult because I have to kind of bounce between the two different routines that I have to do on each event. So I'm doing extra numbers, training extra hard, doing just a lot more than I probably should be doing. But I don't know, I'm excited for the Olympics.
Well, I would hope so. Yeah, but they're not here yet. So we're working like for this season. Next steps, you got a couple more meets going on. Mm-hmm. What are we working on? Oh, yeah, well, you know what? Let's get to the 10-0 right off the bat. Let's talk about your 10, which you deserved, by the way. If you wouldn't have washed over on the bars, you could have had the 10.
See, me personally, I didn't think it was 10, but...
The beam, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't think it was a 10, but I honestly think my bar routine was better.
It was. You just missed your blind full a little, but...
Yeah.
Your beam routine, I feel like it's worth it, so I think you got to take it when they give it to you. It was nice.
Yeah.
It was definitely worth it, and you stuck your landing. That was a big deal.
Because
that's a new dismount.
That is a new dismount, so like I was kind of nervous
old.
For that.
Like, not even a month.
Like, a couple weeks old.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. Yeah, and explain why we're doing the dismount. Why, you know, explain that.
Just because I feel like in the past I've had issues like landing short on my double back dismount. So this time it's like
we don't want an ankle, right, or
yes,
something like this.
Trying to make it easier for the upcoming season.
Yeah, and you got to survive this season. I'm assuming that's the goal.
Yes, that is the goal because I'm doing college season. I'm going straight into classes and championships. So it's going to be a crazy season.
Yeah, it's already kind of a crazy season. At least from my perspective, you did great. Your team did really well. You had a couple of hiccups, but a 197.3 something here in the opening meet's got to be a big boost for you guys.
Yeah, it is a pretty big deal. I mean, we did really good for the first meet of the season as a team, and we were talking about that earlier, so we're all super proud.
Yeah, I think if you can build on that, it's going to be really nice for the rest of the season.
Yes, so I'm excited for the rest of the season because it's going to be great.
Awesome. Thank you, Suni Lee, Olympic all-around champion and the all-around champion in tonight's Super 16 finale. And thank you to Jess. But I wanted to know what you thought of his velvet jacket. Was that a 10?
I wanted to know, too. I mean, this is literally one of the best outfits I think I've ever seen in my life. And we just haven't talked about it, you know?
So talk about this weekend as a whole. What an opening to the women's collegiate season. Your thoughts?
Absolutely. I mean, we saw some real heat tonight from all four teams today, and with this being the first meet of the year, I think we have high expectations for the upcoming season. We saw some fantastic energy just from all four teams. Great teamwork in between. It's what gymnastics is all about.
Talk about Suni for a second, because I don't think it can be stated enough. She's kind of redefining, along with Jade Carey and Jordan Childs a bit, redefining how an elite can participate in college. Mm-hmm. And just the rigors, too, of going to a World Championships if you're Jordan Childs and Jade Carey, and last year going to Olympics if you're Suni, and then coming back to a college season, balancing school. Talk about that challenge a bit.
Oof. I mean, the juggle between school, like just student athletes in general. You strip any titles and anything, being a student athlete is so incredibly difficult. And these women, Jordan, Suni, everybody, Jade, they're just really changing the game. I mean, I cannot express how tired they must be going into the elite season, going into a collegiate season, and then also juggling school. I'm mind blown, truly.
Quickly, what do you think it could mean to elite gymnastics if college could almost become a springboard back into elite?
Oof, that's a great question. I mean,
you got 10 seconds to answer it.
The point, I think my main point is just that you can have it all. You really can have it all. You don't have to just pick one. You can achieve every dream that you want.
Thank you, Lori. Here are your final scores again. Congratulations to the Oklahoma Sooners. Congratulations to all those teams. What an incredible finale to this Super 16 gymnastics competition. What an opening to the collegiate season. For Lori Hernandez and Didi Bro and Jess Graba, I am John Roethlisberger. So long from Las Vegas. What a show these athletes put on here at the Orleans Arena. So long, everybody.